Straight like no one.
Holy name. God, I ask even now, Lord God, that you begin to send revival to your people.
Squeeze that neck.
moment today.
You deserve it. You deserve it.
He's drawing you in today.
You deserve it. You deserve it. You deserve it.
Come on, lift those hands and worship God in this place.
You know that you'll need to get to the hospital.
Whenever you become very hungry and you don't have any food in your refrigerator, you could be like Pastor Ricky and go out to get something to eat. Go out to the fast food restaurants and get to service your needs. Whenever there is a man who is highly interested in a young lady, he's interested in pursuing her. It doesn't matter where she is located in the United States of America, if he really needs her in his life, he will move mountains, he will leap over walls, he will go through the trenches in order to get to this young lady. Today, Sanctum God, I'm preaching to some people who know without a shout of a doubt, you got to get to God. By all means necessary, your family and your children are depending on you to get to God. The reason why you got to get to God, because everything you need is at the well. You ought to touch somebody beside the same neighbor. Everything you need is at the well. So if I got to press my way, if I got to crawl, if I got to hop, if I got to skip, if I got to turn around in order for me to get to the well, by all means necessary, I have to get to the well. So within our text today, Saint of God, we have a Samaritan woman, and she has to get to the well. The Bible does not state her name, so the woman at the well, she is nameless. Would you help understand, Saint of God, in this particular time, in the biblical times, a name was not simply a label, but it was relatively your identity. For some women, they were identified by what they did, the condition they had, or where they stayed. So there was a woman in the Gospel of John, the 8th chapter, who was brought to Jesus because she was caught in the midst of adultery. But because of what she did, she was identified as the woman caught in adultery. But we still do not know her name. There was also a woman in the Gospel of Luke, the 7th chapter, who was a sinner. And she knew Jesus was the guest in the home of the Pharisee, and despite her simple nature, she had the audacity to anoint Jesus' feet. Because she was a sinner, she was identified as the simple woman who anointed Jesus' feet. But after all the sins she committed that were not listed in the text, we still do not know her name. There was also a woman in the Gospel of Luke, the 21st chapter, verse 4. She was poor, and the Bible tells us that she cast in more than the rich people, the rich men in the text. And she had given the largest offering of the day because she gave all that she had. Because she sacrificed everything, she was identified as the generous widow. But we still do not know her name. Last but not least, there is a woman in the Gospel of Mark, the 5th chapter, and she was bleeding for 12 long years. And because of her condition, she was identified as the woman with the issue of blood. However, it didn't matter how much blood that she had lost, this woman in the text was identified as the woman with the issue of blood, and we still don't know her name. Now, we don't know the exact reason why women were nameless. Maybe perhaps there was societal oppression of women within this culture. In biblical times, women, they legally could not be educated, could be counted in the census, and they could not bear witness in the court. They couldn't leave their home and travel publicly without a male escort. So now we are dealing with the woman living in Samaria, and she has been identified as the Samaritan woman, but we still don't know her name. We do not know her name, but what we do know is we know her background. We know her background. If you read John, the 4th chapter, verse 16, Jesus told the Samaritan woman, "Go get your husband and bring him here." She told Jesus, "I don't have a husband." And Jesus responded, "You had 5 husbands, and the man you're living with right now is not your husband." So based on her history, based on her background, it seems like she is always unstable and always in unhealthy relationships. It seems like she has been through marriage after marriage, causing her to go from man to man. Perhaps the Samaritan woman has one-night stand. Maybe she has been identified as a whoremonger or a prostitute because she is living with a man who isn't her husband. I'm getting ready to go somewhere. But despite her inability to keep a man, despite all of her baggage, despite probably being a one-night stand, this dysfunctional woman has been identified in the text as a Samaritan woman. In other words, instead of identifying her as a one-night stand, the text replaces her as a one-night stand by covering her as the Samaritan woman. Because I need somebody in this place to begin to testify that you are just like the woman caught in adultery. You were caught doing some stuff that you had no business doing. You were caught doing some stuff and that was unpleasing in the eyesight of God. You were just like the simple woman who anointed Jesus' feet. You sinned and you fell short of the glory of God, but you didn't allow your sin to stop you from getting to God. You were just like the generous widow. You were financially challenged. You didn't have two dimes to rub together, but you still managed to give God an offering in the house of the Lord. And some of you were just like the Samaritan woman. You were dysfunctional. You were in some relationships that you were ashamed of. So instead of exposing her name, the Bible covers her name. I need somebody to give God glory in this place, because we were all sinners. We were identified the one who was cussing all the time. We're the one who were identified by smoking and drinking and sleeping around. But God, he looked beyond your faults and he saw your needs. Because the Bible says, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things passed away. Behold, all things are become new. So instead of identifying her as the woman, as a one-night stand, the woman who could not keep a man, she was identified as a Samaritan woman. How do y'all know that God, he will cover you despite of all the stuff that you did? So with all of the domestic issues that she has going on in her life, the Samaritan woman had no other choice but to get to the well. There is a providential reason why you must get to the well. Pastor Ricky, why do I have to get to the well? Point number one on today, the reason why you need to get to the well, number one, you can draw strength from the well. Yeah. Lord have mercy, I just love how the Holy Ghost works. The Bible says in the Gospel of John, the 4th chapter, in our text, verse 6, that Jesus, he is weary from his journey. And some of you all in here, you've grown weary. You've been tired. You've become exhausted. You're tired when you wake up. You're tired when you go to sleep at night. You're tired on your job. You're tired in school. You're weary and you're well doing. And every now and then, you just need a boost of energy to get you back on the right track. But I come today to tell you that if you can just get to the well, you can draw some strength from the well. And the reason why you can draw strength from the well is because there is a man named Jesus who is waiting for you at the well. And whenever you make a decision to get to the well, not only do you get the living water, but you also get the strength from the living water. Because whenever you are physically exhausted and you drink some water, you regain your focus and you get your strength back. So what you have to understand on today's saints of God is that whenever you get close to Jesus, you enter into his presence. And whenever you enter into his presence, you gain access to everything he has. And how many of y'all know that the joy of the Lord is my strength? Which suggests if I can just get to the well and get in his presence, I'll get Jesus, I'll get his joy, and I'll get his strength. I just want to know, does anybody need the strength of God on today? Can somebody put those hands together for the strength of God being released in your life? Look at your neighbor, say, neighbor, everything you need is at the well. Everything you need is at the well. So point number one, you can draw strength from the well. The second reason why you need to get to the well, point number two, you just may find what you've been looking for. You just may find what you've been looking for. And some of you in this church on today came out the AOP, and some of you have experienced some rough patches recently in your life. It's been rough in your mind. It's been rough in your emotions. It's been rough in your career. It's been rough on the job. It's been rough concerning your business. It's been rough in your marriage. Pastor, it's just been a little complicated. And I was seeking the Lord in prayer. The Lord began to minister to me. He said, Ricky, the reason why I allowed you to endure some rough patches in your life, because my intent was to just draw you to the well. I don't know who needs to hear that today. So if some of you all came in this church, if you've been looking for clarity on the day, God's purpose, his intent was to draw you to the well. His intent was to draw you to the well, to remind you that everything that you need is at the well. So if you've been looking for answers and you've been looking for solutions to your problems, but whatever you do, be sure to also look in the right places. You have to look in the right places. Searching them in all of the wrong places. And the man whom she has been living with was not her husband. So the Samaritan woman said to God, she was looking, she was searching in all the wrong places, trying to find out what she needed in the man. But what she needed to do was to simply get to the well. She needed to get to the well because apparently there was a void in her life. There was an empty spot. There was a vacancy in her life. And whenever there is a void in your life, whenever there is an empty space in your life, you will look in all the wrong places in order to fill the void that's in your life. So you've been looking, you've been searching, saints of God, but some of us, we've been looking in the wrong direction. And I came today as your pastor to save you a whole lot of time. I came to save you a whole lot of money, energy, and stress, and to let you know that everything you need is at the well. So for everybody in this church who's been looking for a new job, for everybody's been looking for the friends to come through for you, you've been looking for other resources to come for you, let me save you some time today to let you know to just get to the well. Touch your mama's head and say, neighbor, all you got to do is just get to the well. Just get to the well. David put it like this, I will look unto the hills from which cometh my help. All of my help come from the Lord. And we tend to say that help is on the way, but I come to activate your faith today to let you know that if you just get to the well, help is here right now. I don't know who needs to be helped in this situation, but the only thing you got to do is just get to the well. So if you've been looking for some consistent income in your life to make the ends meet, if you can just get to the well, if you can just get to the well, you will soon discover that he's Jehovah Jireh, the God who provides. If you've been looking for God to heal your body, if you can just get to the well, you will soon discover that he's Jehovah Rapha, the God who heals. And things may be falling apart in your life. Things may have become broken in your life. But if you can just get to the well, child of God, you will soon discover that God can mend your brokenness. You'll soon discover that he can be your peace. You'll soon discover if you can just get to the well, he'll be your joy. And if you so happen to be empty, if you so happen to be drained mentally, if you so happen to be exhausted, if you can just get to the well, he's the God who can fill you up. I need somebody to lift your hands in this place and say, Lord, fill me up. Just get to the well, because you just may find what you've been looking for. So you just may find what you've been looking for. One of my last points, the last reason why you must get to the well. Point number three, you don't have to pay for this living water. You don't have to pay for this living water. In other words, this living water that is available to you, it is free of charge. The Bible says in John the 4th chapter, verse 13, Jesus answered and said to her, whoever drinks of this water will thirst again. But whoever drinks of the water that I shall give him will never thirst. But the water that I shall give him will become in him a fountain of water springing up into everlasting life. In order to support this, Revelation 21 and 6 says, and he said to me, it is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, God, is that you may think that the water you drink every day is free of charge. But the water you drink every single day, it comes with a cost. Yeah. Well, Pastor Ricky, I drink free water from my house. I drink free water at school. I drink free water on my job from the water fountain. But I don't mean to bust your bubbles this morning, saints of God. But the water that you're drinking here and everywhere, there is something that happens at the end of the month. So after you get done drinking your free water on your at the house, from school, and on your job, this company called EPB sends you a bill at the end of the month, and somebody has to pay for the water that you consumed of. But what you have to understand, saints of God, and I feel like preaching, there is another type of water called the living water. This living water has already been paid in full. This living water has been paid in full by a man named Jesus. I come today to let somebody know that this living water, it can never run out to me. This living water that I'm talking about, Fiji, the Sonic, and my cousin Aquafina ain't got nothing on this living water. Because I know that if I drink this natural water, I know that I'll get thirsty again. I know that I'll become dehydrated. But I know that if I just get to the living water, if I get this living water on the inside of me,
today, God, he breaks the cycle today. But in order for God
him to come to the well. Every head bowed, every eye closed. If you know that you need to get to the well, if there's a thing that you need God to do in your life, come today to let you know that everything you need is at the well. So the altar is available for you if you need a refreshing in your spirits. If you need strength on today, we want you to get down into this altar and get to the well.
Give to God.
let water things begin to flow in your life. Amen. So get that offering in your hands. Let me get my debit card, credit card. See Miss Kiki. God bless this praise and worship team. Amen. Put our hands together. Y'all sing it, Miss Kiki.